David Rubrik, and welcome back to Supermarket Sweep. Now, interestingly enough, the ice cream cone was created by accident. It originated in my hometown at the St. Louis World's Fair in 1904, when a baker of waffles noticed his customers putting another merchant's ice cream on top of the waffle. So, putting two and two together, or in this case, one and one together, the baker began rolling the cakes into cylinders to hold the ice cream, and voila, the world's first ice cream cone was born. All right, let's say hello again to Jenny, Tamara, and Jim. Welcome back. You ready to play? We have a real close game, only 10 seconds separating the teams. Now remember, the more time you earn here, the more time you get to spend in the market trying to win the sweep and going for $5,000. Okay. Let's see what kind of shoppers you are. Look at these three items. We have an 18-ounce bag of Mother's Oatmeal Raisin Cookies, $2.57. A 28-ounce jar of Peter Pan Extra Crunchy Peanut Butter, $3.69. And a 15-ounce box of Nabisco Frosted Wheat Square Cereal, $3.35. Just like you'd see out on the supermarket shelf, right? Except one of these is on sale. Tell me which one you think it is. Is it number one, number two, or number three that is on sale? Now, if you're right, you get 10 extra seconds during your sweep. All three of you get it right, it's going to be another 20 seconds on top of that. All right, Jenny, which one did you say was on sale?
I said the Mother's Cookies, number one.
You're going for the yummy little Mother's Cookies. Tamara, did you agree?
No, I didn't. I chose number three, the Frosted Wheat Squares.
You're going for the cereal, okay. And how about you, Jim?
I also chose number three, the Frosted Wheat Squares.
Oh, you went for the cereal. Okay, let's see, which one of these three products is on sale? It is the cereal. It actually costs $3.75. So Tamara gets 10 seconds, and Jim gets 10 seconds. So, oh, look at how close the game. It still is only 10 seconds separating everybody. Here's our next game. Take a look at this. These are a series of blank spaces representing the number of letters of a product. I'm going to give you a clue as to what the product is. I will then reveal the word one letter at a time, starting with the last letter. The first player to buzz in and correctly identify the product will win 10 seconds. So get your hands on your buzzers. Here's the first one, and there are six letters in the word. The clue is, it's all washed up. L. O. D. Y. X. Jenny.
Oxidol.
Let's see. There you go. Good for you, Jenny. That's 10 seconds for you, and that moves you into a tie for the lead with Jim. Here's the next one. There are nine letters in this word, and the clue is, give this person a hand. E, V, I. Tamara.
Palmolive.
Check it out. That is it. Okay, good. Look at this. Holy mackerel, we have a three-way tie for the lead. Everybody has 2 minutes. Uh-oh, it's going to be a great sweep. Here's the last one. There are seven letters in the word, and the clue is, it gets all steamy in the morning. S, R, E. Tamara.
Quakers.
Let's see. No. E, G. Jenny.
Folgers.
Let's see. That is it. Okay, very good. Good for you, Jenny. That moves you into the lead. You're in the lead by 10 seconds with 2 minutes and 10 seconds. Tamara and Jim, you each have 2 minutes. Oh, this is going to be great. Let's get your partners up here for the round robin game. Oh, boy. Now, this is a chance to really add on to your sweep time because the round robin has a total of 6 questions and the chance to earn up to 60 seconds. And with a game this close, it can be anybody's game. Partners, stand by. You're going to be up next. What I'm going to do is give you 5 clues about a product. As soon as you think you can match the clue to the product, buzz in and give us the answer. If you're right, you win 10 seconds. If you're wrong, of course, you're locked out just for that question and the other players can buzz in. Get your hands on your buzzers. Here's the first one. Sweet. Friends. Swashbucklers. Tamara.
Three Musketeers bar.
That's it. Okay, change. Good for you. Now you're tied for the lead. Edna, you're only 10 seconds behind. Here's the next one. Sweetened. Wheat. Puffs. Happening Frog. Edna.
Sugar Crisp?
No. Lee.
Sugar Smacks?
No. Dig'em. Sweetened Wheat Puffs. Happening Frog. Dig'em.
I don't know.
Oh, it's Kellogg's Honey Smacks.
Oh.
Nobody gets 10 seconds. That's okay. Change. We still have a two-way tie for the lead, and Jim, you're only 10 seconds behind. See if you can catch up on this one. Dry mix. Box. Broth. Tamara.
Lipton cup of soup?
Yes, it is. Okay, good. Change, change. Here's the next one. Dessert, desert-like. Protection. Lee.
Oasis?
No. Edna.
Dry idea?
No. Oh, no. Underarm. Extra, extra dry. Valley.
Aaron.
That's what we were looking for. Okay, change. Change, change. Oh, they're moving out in the lead. You got two more chances, Jenny and Tim, to catch up with them. Miniature. Coated. E.T.'s favorite. Jim.
Reese's Pieces.
Okay, that's it. Change. There's a man with five kids. He would know about E.T. and eat Reese's Pieces. Okay, here's the last one in the round robin game. Bowlful. Breakfast. Champions. And Lee.
Wheaties?
That's it, of course. Wheaties, breakfast champion. So let's see what we have here. Well, there's still only 10 seconds separating everybody. Valley and Tamara, you have 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Jenny and Lee, you have 2 minutes and 20 seconds. And that $50 that you picked up in the mini sweep. Edna and Jim, you have 2 minutes and 10 seconds. This is going to be a great sweep. Who's going to run it? Lee, Valley, and Edna. So don't go away. When we come back, you're going to see Edna, Valley, and Lee running like mad through our aisles at a chance for $5,000 here on Supermarket Sweep.